Welcome back, everyone. I'm Jonathan Blackwood with Commercial Integrator on behalf of HD Base T. We are streaming live from ISE 2020 at the HD Base T booth, and I'm lucky to be joined by Tom Devine of AV Pro Edge. Tom, thank you for joining us.
Hey, thanks for having me. I appreciate it.
It's great to have you. So tell us a little bit about AV Pro Edge and what you guys are doing here at the show.
Sure. Well, you know, we're back at ISE. We're very excited. It's always a very fun show for us. We're from the United States, right in the middle of nowhere called South Dakota. So when we get to come and see all these different cultures and all these people from different countries, it's really great. And then when I get to see those people that talk about our products, I absolutely love it. So it's really nice to be here. AV Pro Edge, what we are is we are a manufacturer of audio video distribution equipment. And what we do is we specialize in 4K and pushing technology. We're all looking at 8K right now, and we want to help the industry move along, and we do that by releasing products that have capabilities you won't find a lot of other places.
Well, there's three products that are new for you guys that I really want to talk about, and the first is a modular switch. Could you tell us about that?
Yes, definitely. So this is a really, really cool product for us. So it's a 16 by 16 matrix switch as a chassis. And what you're able to do is, for any of the 16 inputs and 16 outputs, you're able to take them and remove them and only purchase the ones you need. So if you need 16 TVs, but you only have 5 sources, then you can purchase that. And vice versa. In turn, building a custom switch for your customer that's going to not only give them exactly what they want, but possibly save them money by not having to pay for all of these ports that are going to be unused. But what makes this really special is you're able to remove the cards, putting new ones in. Those new ones can be anything. So we have HDMI only cards, we have fiber optic cards, we have our standard HD Base T cards is what it normally comes with. And each one of these cards has 2 HD Base T ports. These HD Base T ports are able to handle full 18 gigabit per second signaling, which, you know, now that everybody's starting to catch up, we need, because we have 4K signals coming in, everyone's looking at HDMI 2.1, and so having that full pipeline open for signaling really makes the difference in the matrix switch and will give life to that installation. On the input, it's standard to come with HDMI, but we have in the works right now HD Base T input cards as well.
Wow.
So if you had sources that were in another room, another rack room, or even further away, you know, this is HD Base T, it could be in another building at a university, and you could still have all your switching happening remotely using HD Base T technology. So the thing about the modular matrix switch is it is adaptable for whatever you want. Do you need audio downmixing? We have it. Dolby 7.1 or Dolby Atmos downmixing can be built into the switch. Do you need to go a certain distance? Well, we have those outputs that can get there for you. It has full audio de-embedded, 100% control, controllable audio de-embedding, as well as we work with all the big control companies, Crestron, Control 4, Elon, the list goes on and on. So no matter how you do your installations, this modular matrix switch can truly be the actual backbone of your installation.
Yeah, it sounds pretty powerful. And something else I've been hearing a lot about is Cloud 9.
Yeah, so the Cloud 9, it's been out for a little while, but so about 3 years now. It's had a resurgence as more and more residential integrators start doing light commercial. They're seeing the income that you can get from putting in a sports bar, putting in maybe a conference room or maybe a event hall that a commercial person doesn't maybe consider full commercial. Well, the Cloud 9 is perfect for that. What it actually is a 9x9 matrix switch, but it's cascadable. So what you're able to do is actually, by adding additional boxes, you can go from 9x9 to 9x200. And then you'd be able to have those 9 sources individually controlled through a control system using the Cloud 9. So how that works is it has HDMI inputs, an HDMI loop out port, and on the outputs, HD Base T only. We have 2 different kind of receivers for the Cloud 9. A standard receiver that's going to give you the full picture, but we also have a video wall receiver, so you could do 3x3 video walls. Another really cool function of the Cloud 9, which makes it perfect for the sports bar, is it has a multi-view mode. So if you have a big projector in the middle of your room, and you have the football games are on, or the, you know, football in America, my soccer here, right? I'm saying it wrong.
Couldn't tell you.
But whatever, you're trying to watch a lot of sources at one time, you have the main projector, you got everybody arguing on what game should I put up. Well, you just throw the multi-view on, we send all 9 sources down the HDBaseT pipe to that one big projector, splitting that signal in, and you can see every single game on the one screen. Oh, the one in the middle, big stuff's happening in that game. Everybody wants to watch that one. You can instantly switch it with no delay at all to that one game. So the Cloud 9 really does become a full solution for many, many applications where people thought, you know, the only way I'm going to be able to do this is AV over IP. Yeah. And we hear that a lot as a manufacturer. But what you don't realize is sending that signal through a network switch, it's not always the most ideal way to distribute video. The way that we use HDBaseT, sending an uncompressed signal, Now we don't have to worry about artifacts, signal degradation, and the different things that you're going to find by maybe having a subpar network switch or not having your pipeline open or having a patch cable in, different things that can affect that signal. When you have a full run of HDBaseT working with the Cloud 9, that's when you get the most optimized picture that you can for your customers.
Okay, and finally, you guys have a scaling receiver that I know is being well received.
Hey, I like it, I love the pun. So, yes, it is being well received. And the thing that makes this so special, right, is, I mean, it's an HDBaseT receiver. We're at ISC.
Yeah.
It's gonna be really hard to find those. Yeah, right, everybody has them. What makes this kind of different, though, is it's a full scaler 480 to 4K. So if no matter what your signal is, you can make sure that it's going to stay on a certain resolution. So if you're distributing Apple TV 4K box, and then you're distributing an old Xbox 360, and then you're distributing, let's say, a security camera, and all of them have different resolutions, and the way your displays work or the way that your pipeline works is that when you're switching through different resolutions, all of a sudden you could find different problems, delays, it's not working right, it's not switching right, because your display is trying to figure out how to switch those resolutions so quickly. What the scaling receiver would do is you set the output. So no matter if your source is 480p or 720 or 10K, you say this display works the best when I send it 1080i. So you set your scaler, your SC2, dash R is what we call it, it's a scaling receiver, but you set it to be 1080i. And then no matter what signal you're getting from that security camera, from that Xbox 360, or from that Apple 4K, it's going to be converted, scaled to 1080i. Your system now is going to work, everything became stable in your pipeline, and your customer's happy.
Yeah, which is the most important
That's
part.
That's right.
Well, plenty of great stuff to check out at the AV Pro Edge booth here at ISE. Tom, thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you so much for sitting down. It's always great to be a part of the HDBaseT family. And yeah, if you're watching this, I'm sorry you weren't able to get to the show, but hey, HDBaseT is bringing you this content the whole time. So, once again, I really appreciate you sitting down. I hope you guys check out AV Pro Edge. We got some really unique solutions. So.